was a whole different story, man. Mori was a whole different story. My camera died. I couldn't stop because I wanted to make sure I'm not stranded at night. Basically, I did not want to waste another day. I crossed Mori Plains, and after that, a couple of more places. So that. I was able to cope with the altitude sickness at all the passes, but I wanted to make sure I give my body some time. So what I thought was I'll do all the lay things that day, including the inner line permit. That day was a Sunday. I thought, dude, man, I am fucked. Sunday, a government office would not work. It was not working. The DC office, because that's where you get your ILP. But the guy was available over there, so he was they are available after 3 on Sundays. That's what I know. I quickly looked around for. So I quickly looked around for a room, a hotel to stay at, and. Chilled myself down, washed, just simply chilled, and after that I went for a stroll, and that turned out to be me finding a fucking great place to eat at. So I found Neha Snacks. This is a small eatery at Leh Market. If I want to locate it for you, if you enter Leh Market from the site Taxi Association offices, you will have to go straight to the T point and then to the left. You will find it on your left. It's a small corner kind of thing, and you will see a lot of tissue papers hanging around right in front with people comment their feedback on it. One would be mine. The reason this place was so amazing is that I was told at Jispa that I would not be getting a lot of food in Leh, a lot of my kind of food or the kind of things we can eat. Basically, I will either be getting Maggi or the regional food that I don't usually eat. So. And. But I found it. I found this place, and they serve amazing quality South Indian, man. This They serve amazing quality South Indian food. The first day I had, I simply had an uttapam and I fucking loved it. The next day, the day I wanted to acclimatize, that day went pretty well because I looked around all the places I wanted to see, which includes I went to Leh Palace. I went to the Gompa right above it. So it's the same old Gompa. I tried to motovlog over there and this is it. So I reached Leh yesterday. That was the fourth day. Just to go to a backstory of it, I wanted to go from Spiti, so I was planning to do Nako, Batal and... I'm sure you kind of know the kind of things I was feeling at that point. That was some Matrix, man. Oh my god. So I did this. I went to the Gompa, I chilled out, and then I headed for Shea Palace. I heard a lot of things about it. So I went to Shea Palace and then I went to Thikse Monastery. Again my camera died on me, even though the battery was full. It was some problem with the climate, I guess. Or I guess I had it in the case. That's why it died, due to the moisture. But I was able to get some good clicks out of it. After that, I went to see the Shanti Stupa. The name is quite contradictory because... So here you see... an on-duty guy with slippers. Oh my god, this is funny. So I saw Shanti Stupa. The name is quite contradictory because it was too crowded, man. A lot of people clicking photographs. You can't even stand at one point because after every minute or so, people will change their direction. They want to click this and that. So you'll be in their field of view. You either out of respect or you are told to get out of the view. So I made sure I quickly get off the place. I got off the place and I came back to the hotel. The hotel staff was moderate. I sort of liked it because I'm not of a luxury loving guy. Basically, I had all the functional stuff over there, so it was what I needed. And that's how the day acclimatization day I was acclimatizing went.